بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد My dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته In this week's episode, I would like to speak to you about what is the best investment that an individual can make in this life. And without a shadow of a doubt, it's an investment that they make for their hereafter. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he tells us that when we pass away, only three things will benefit us. Knowledge that we left behind, that people acted upon, a Sadaqah Jariyyah, a continuous charity that continues to benefit us even after we pass away, and then a righteous child that we leave behind that continues to pray for us and seek forgiveness for us. These are the only three things that will continue to benefit us after we pass away. Now, what I want to focus on in this week's episode is this concept of a Sadaqah Jariyyah, this continuous charity. In another hadith narrated by Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, he narrates from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سبع يجري للعبد أجرهن من بعد موته وهو في قبره من علم علما أو كرى نهرا أو حفر بئرا أو غرس نخلا أو بنى مسجدا أو ورث مصحفا أو ترك ولدا يستغفر له بعد موته That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that seven deeds of a servant will continue to be rewarded after his death while he is in his grave. Number one, knowledge that he left behind that people acted upon. Number two, constructing a canal, meaning a pathway for water for the people. Number three, digging a well. Number four, planting a date palm tree. And this date palm tree is not restricted to that, but the date palm tree, it provides shade for the traveler and also provides fruit. And also you can use the leaves to build and construct. So it's a multifaceted, multi-purpose tree that people can benefit from. Then he mentions building a masjid, writing down or handing down rather a copy of the Quran that people share with one another and they read from. And then last but not least, leaving behind a righteous child that seeks forgiveness for them after their death. And this hadith, it explains the concept of a Sadaqah Jariyyah, meaning deeds that we should be focusing on so that we can continue to reap their rewards even after we pass away. So providing water for people either through building that canal or building a well, planting trees that people benefit from, building masajid, giving copies of the Quran as gifts. These are all examples that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentions. In another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam even mentions those that provide shelter for travelers. So housing for individuals that are traveling, that would also be considered a Sadaqah Jariyyah. It is with this inspiration and with the hopes of benefiting our beloved brother, Abdulla Barahim, Rahimahullah Ta'ala, that passed away, we at the IISC are partnering up with IDRF to build two wells, and inshallah, maybe even more than that, in the Aden and Hadramaut areas of Yemen. One of them will be a solar-powered, water-generating well, and then the other one will be a typical well construction that is considered a deep well. Each well, inshallah, will benefit 900 to 1,500 people, and it will have a longer than usual lifetime, whereas the single hand pump wells, they just last for a couple of years, 2 to 5. This, inshallah, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, will be 10 years plus with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we're hoping to do these in Yemen because that's where our beloved brother Abdullah Barahim was from. So this is just an opportunity for myself and all of you to be involved in this great project of building these water wells in Yemen. It is a water-scarce country. It is a poverty-stricken country. It is a country that is going through famine and through much turmoil. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make things easy for them and all of the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, wherever they may be in this world. So my dear brothers and sisters, let us focus on investing in our hereafter. And this is a great opportunity to invest in a Sadaqah Jariyyah project on behalf of our wonderful and beloved and greatly missed brother, Abdullah Barahim, rahimahullahu ta'ala. You can find more details, inshallah, on our website, www.iisc.ca. And inshallah, we will be sending email reminders and social media reminders as well. So you can find more information there as well, particularly on our Facebook page. So I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the tawfiq to invest in our hereafter. and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts from us the deeds that we do, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives and overlooks any of the mistakes that our brothers and sisters that have passed away have had, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts them from the righteous and grants them the best of rewards and makes things easy for their families that they have left behind. Allahumma ameen. Jazakum Allah khairan for tuning in. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.